Hi Pisces, if you guys haven't seen me, if you guys haven't heard me tell you, I'm at Danielle's house. That's why the background hair is different. So anyways, I feel like I'm picking up an energy for you guys where I feel like something needs to be cleared up. All right, there's the Lovers, Gemini energy, and then there's this home, this marriage. This is a union that is supposed to last the ages. It's supposed to last. It's not supposed to go anywhere. That is the King and the Queen of Pentacles right there. But you seem to be questioning it with the Lovers. Spirits, what does Pisces need to know right now? Pisces. Right now, at the time you're viewing this message is when you're meant to receive these messages, Pisces. Let's see what's going on here. Something needs to be cleared up. You have the Knight of Pentacles as your first card. And then you have the Page of Wands. And the Chariot, Cancer energy. The Six of Wands. The Queen of Swords in the center of your reading. Did I say the Six of Swords? I'm not sure. We may see the Six of Swords here. If I did, that's the Queen of Swords. And then you have the Page of Pentacles. The Two of Wands. The Nine of Wands. And the Four of Wands. On the bottom of the deck is the King of Pentacles and the Two of Swords. Yeah, something here needs to be cleared up about this King of Pentacles. All right, and don't get hung up on the gender. There's someone here that wants to be in your life for the long term. This person feels like you're actually the perfect match. Tell me why the Knight of Pentacles is here. You have the Eight of Wands. I don't know how that happened. I must have shuffled the cards backwards. You have the Lovers, Gemini energy in reverse, and you have Judgment. It happened for a reason. It's like you have some type of a plan with this person, but judgment has been delayed. A decision has been delayed. And I'm seeing you still in page energy here where you're still unsure. And then you have the Chariot, Cancer. The Hanged Man, this is your energy, Pisces. Feelings. Feeling stuck. You know what, Pisces? You know what the issue is here? You can see it right there. The Three of Wands is here on the bottom of the deck. There's someone here in your energy, Pisces, that you want them to do things a certain way, if this is your energy. If not, there's a lot of other readings, and those readings will catch you at the time you're meant to receive them. But if this is your energy, there's something here where the person that you're dealing with, they feel at a loss with you. They're not sure whether they're coming or going, because if this person stopped and followed your rules, if they stopped what they were doing here, because I see someone here that's really busy with the Eight of Wands, if they were to stop this busyness, it would stop you. It would stop you, and you're in Chariot energy. Like you're always moving, you're always going. You don't want this person to go with you everywhere you go. Spirits are telling you to look at the bigger picture. There's someone here that you want them to be a certain way, but the only reason you're with them is because of the way they are. If this person was just right there by your side, you wouldn't want them. It's like you're a go-getter. It's like you have, I mean, this person's by your side, but it's the same kind of energy I picked up for you guys like a couple days ago. There's someone here in the energy where they're in here for the long run. They don't want to go anyplace. Everything runs smoothly between the two of you, but you feel stuck. You feel stuck in your mind, and you're not really sure what direction to move in with this person. You're obviously the Queen of Swords, which is showing up in the center of your reading. So you're just waiting to use that sword and cut this person off. But if you really think about it, if you look at the bigger picture, if this is your energy, if this person stopped, they're gonna irritate you. You're not gonna want them there anymore. It's gonna leave you stuck. It's gonna leave you feeling exhausted. Because in Chariot energy, it's like you have your own stuff going on. You have your own stuff that you want to do. And if this is you, you're the type of person who wants to be running around and doing what you want to do without someone asking questions all the time. And I don't see like a cheating energy or nothing like this. This is just an energy here of you being busy. Like you have stuff to do here. There's people waiting for you. This is not easy to achieve what you have achieved. And so there needs to be an understanding here to take a look at the bigger picture. Because you may be placing judgment on someone here when they're actually exactly what you want, what you manifested. Tell me why the Six of Wands is here and you're just not recognizing that this is what you manifested. You have Temperance, the High Priestess. Yeah, because there's this other energy here, Pisces, this other direction that you go in where it's like you find peace there, you find happiness there. You're recognized here in this energy with the Six of Wands. This is where you find your peace of mind. It's a it's fun to be with this person, but if this person were to follow the rule book, judgment, the rules that you seem to be setting down are kind of screwed up because the rules only apply to you of the freedom, and I hope I'm putting that into the right words. Tell me why it's like this immature way of thinking about this connection. Tell me why the Queen of Swords is here. There's like a past energy that's inside of you that is very skeptical and feels like you should demand more. The Sun is here, Leo energy, that needs to heal. And the Five of Swords is there. There's something here that it's like you're fighting it though. The next card you have is the Page of Pentacles. So you could be arguing with whoever this is and actually get what you want, and then you're unhappy, and then you're exhausted, you're tired. Like, why did I want this? Why is the Page of Pentacles here? The Six of Pentacles. See, look, there's the Queen of Pentacles. The two of you are supposed to be together. There's an energy here of equal give and take. This is not unequal give and take. This is the King and the Queen of Pentacles. So if you get everything that you want, if this person comes forward and they give you everything that you want, everything that you're asking of them, it's going to leave you in the exact same position you're in now because you're going to be saying, this isn't what I want. Be careful what you wish for, you just might get it. Tell me why the Two of Wands is here. Because whoever this person is, they want to work with you. You know, they want this to work. And with the Ace of Wands right there, they want a new beginning with you. This could have ended, all right? For some of you, not for all of you, but for some of you, this could have ended already. And right at first, this may leave you feeling excited, like, yeah, let's do everything together. Let's do it all together. Let's be together and do everything together. But then it leaves you like the wounded warrior. Like you're putting up walls, you're putting up your defenses because of the rules, because of the book. Tell me why the Nine of Wands is here. Something's holding on by a thread. There's two doorways behind you that you can go through. This is Scorpio energy. There's two ways this can go, and whichever way it goes, it's up to you, Pisces. Because here in the future, you feel like the wounded warrior. I kind of feel like you're going to get everything that you want. You're going to get this person telling you, okay, we're going to do everything together. This will be a new beginning. We'll do everything together. Tell me why the Four of Wands is here. You have the Four of Pentacles. And the Nine of Swords. You're overthinking this, Pisces, and you could be hurting someone's feelings here and missing out on your person. Because you're feeling very defensive. All right. And there's actually something here that you're keeping to yourself. All right. Some information that you're keeping to yourself. And that is I see you, you may not even realize it. So that may be why you're not even mentioning it. But there's this place where you plant seeds, this garden, and you can't just stay in this one place. It's like there's many seeds. There's a huge garden here that you're working on. So when I look into the future, there's a reunion here. But there's also a warning here, because I'm seeing you really having a hard time sleeping, feeling tired from holding on too tightly. So let's look at the energy of your person. They show up as the King of Pentacles. And then there's the energy of you. I'm not sure what direction to go in with the Two of Swords. Tell me why the King of Pentacles is here. This person is actually a twin, you know, like a twin, like they mirror you. You have strength. Leo energy. This person's holding on to you. They don't want to let you go. The world is here. This person, they might be a different nationality than you, with the world showing up here. And then you have the Three of Cups. It's very, very difficult for this person to be without you. And I see a reconciliation here on their mind. They think the world of you. Why is the Two of Swords here? They could even tell you that. And see, you don't think before you react here with the Knight of Swords energy. The Seven of Pentacles. Because it's like as if you're spending time waiting, and the Devil is here, Capricorn energy. You need to make a decision on this energy right here, if this is you, because the Devil is here. All right, there's this obsessive energy, and there's this need for you to have this freedom. With Nine of Pentacles, like you need this. If you don't have this energy, if you don't have this freedom, this free time, you're gonna walk away from this person. And I, if this is your energy, you want to stay here with this person, the King and the Queen of Pentacles. You want to. You're overthinking something. You're questioning something, because there's this healing inside of you that needs to be done. There's this traditional way of thinking that you have that doesn't really exist here in the current and in the present moment. You're somehow living the energy of the rule book, or how things used to be in the past, with someone else or something else. It doesn't apply here any longer. And I see you coming to this realization, this understanding, you know, because be careful what you wish for, you know, which doorway you go through. All right, Pisces, let's get your moonology cards for advice. You have the energy is gaining momentum, and this is waxing moon. And a new romantic cycle begins, new moon in Libra. I see a reconciliation coming to an understanding and a time for healing. This is balsamic moon. Pisces, I love you guys. Thank you for being here with me. Thank you for taking the time to like and subscribe. And take care of you, Pisces, and we'll meet back up here again tomorrow. Namaste.